Everyone, this is Saturn. This is the first serious video on my channel. I have been using it for a long time now just to post random and silly stuff, so at this point I have absolutely no idea what I'm doing, so bear with me if I get sidetracked. Anyways, today I'm gonna teach you how to make a rather simple, event-based stamina bar that shows up on the screen and depletes itself as the player runs on RPG Maker VX Ace. You can download the demo in the description box. Later on, since it was also requested, we are going to make one of these for HP that starts getting depleted if the stamina's value reaches 0. So, for making this happen, we are going to use two common events. One for the actual process of depleting and regenerating stamina, that will be called stamina cog in this example, and another one for the graphical display, or the HUD if you prefer, called stamina bar. We're also going to need a way of globally turning dashing off, without messing with the map settings, and for that, I have found a simple solution. It requires a bit of scripting, but it's literally just one line of code. If you don't feel confident to follow these steps, you can also get the script by following the link in the description. It is a little bit longer than what we're going to do here, but that's because I've made it in a way that lets you customize it without having to deal with any code at all. We need to go to the Game Player page in the Game Objects category. Find the line 137, add the line below it, and write return false if $game_switches open bracket number and close bracket. In this example, we are going to use the switch number 2. If you prefer, you can copy it over to a new page in the Material section. Also, remember to delete the new line from the other page. After doing that, though, it's also needed to copy the line 9 from the Game Player page, paste it above everything, and type end below everything. Now, our description required is done. Let's move on. Starting with the stamina bar event, we have to set it up as a parallel process with a condition switch of your liking. For the tutorial's sake, we're just going to call it stamina. Also, a variable will be needed for this. We're going to use the number 1. We need two pictures, one for the HUD and one for the bar. We are adding the HUD first with a show picture command. Be sure to set its position properly. The bar picture is a little different. We're going to make it appear with a script call, so I can set its size to be relative to the stamina variable. You can just copy it from the screen and change the numbers as you need it. Now that we are done with the stamina bar, we need to make an event on the map to turn the stamina switch on. In your game, you can just sneak that right at the end of the intro cutscene, for example. Gonna keep it simple here, just set it to auto run, make it set the value of the stamina variable to 100, so we start the game with it full, turn the stamina switch on, self switch A on, and a new blank page for when the self switch A is on, so the event doesn't repeat itself and freezes the game. At this point, we might want to test it just to see if the stamina bar shows up. It won't do anything yet besides, well, being there, but it's important to check its position to adjust if necessary. Since that's good, we can get to the main eventing now. In the stamina calculation event, after setting it to parallel process with the stamina switch, the first thing we had to do is set two conditions up, one to check if the player is dashing, and another one to check movement, both using simple script calls that you can copy from the screen. Inside the movement condition, let's set up the depletion of stamina, making it decrease the variable by the percentage you want, then with a frame so it doesn't consume our tons. At this point, the stamina goes down, but doesn't stop at zero nor regenerates. To fix that, let's continue the event. First by setting a condition that says if the stamina is zero or below, the dash is disabled. If not, it keeps going down. We do that by moving the subtraction and weight inside the else part of the branch. We also add a wait command after disabling the dashing to avoid spam. Now, if the player isn't moving nor dashing, the stamina should regenerate. In the else section of the dashing condition, we create a label named regen and create a condition that checks if the stamina is equal or above 100. If it's equal to 100 or above, it does nothing. If it's less, it waits a little, increases the value, and enables the dashing again by turning the switch to off. If the player is moving, but the dash is disabled, the event jumps back to the regen label. Now let's test the game and see if it works. After tests playing and setting the values to your liking, we can make the HP related events. One will be called HP deplete and the other HP bar. The HP bar event is pretty much the same as the stamina bar one, just changing the HUD's position a little, and instead of using the stamina variable to determine the bar size, we are going to use a script call called HP rate, that is the number resulting from dividing the current HP for the max HP. Also, we are going to multiply it by 100 so it looks like a percentage. If you need to, just copy it from the screen. Also, do not forget to change the picture's indexes. On the HP deplete event, we are going to set a wait command and a condition checking if the stamina variable is equal or below 0. If it's not, the event doesn't do anything. If it is, the HP of the first actor is decreased. We can also add an effect, so the player knows the HP is being drained. Let's playtest. Looks alright so far. It just needs a few touches and it's done. So, as I said before, it was my first attempt ever at a decent video. I tried to make it understandable enough, but if it's not, you are always free to ask questions in the comments. I hope you enjoyed. Thanks for watching. Bye.